What is up, everybody? My name is Parker Ament.
My name's Danny Ferrari.
And we are XLNT Sound. Woo. Today we have a huge video for you guys.
A smacker.
It's actually a little video.
It's a little beaut.
It's a little beauty.
A little beaut of a video for you guys.
A little beauty of a Fisher video.
A little beaut of Fisher.
This is a super, super sick song. I love it. But before we even get into any of this stuff, we have a huge announcement.
A giant announcement.
A giant announcement. I mean, it's technically an announcement.
It's kind of an announcement.
Kind of.
It's definitely a sample pack, but the genre, I guess, is kind of debatable.
It's like four on the floor.
It's house, but it's...
There's like bass
in it. There's bass in it, but it's
there's
not...
drums.
It's not bass house.
No, it's not bass house.
It's
technically house, guys.
It's technically house, guys.
Boom. There it is.
Tech house, baby.
Look at that beautiful blue box.
And you guys know, as always, what we do is we got a ton of sick-ass tech house remakes planned for you guys in the future, which we will be doing a bunch of content coming.
There's so many new videos for you guys. We have crazy remakes for you. Some, like, extra videos that we've never done before.
Mm-hmm.
Some great nugs of knowledge for you.
Oh, yeah. Some different type of content, too, besides just remakes. A lot of production stuff coming out. We're going to tell you guys a ton about that in the next video. But right now, we just wanted to let you guys know that October 1st is the date that technically house will be out.
It'll technically be out
on October 1st. So get ready. Make sure you guys enjoy this video. Click the link in the description if you guys want to grab both presets. You're doing two.
Yeah, we're doing two sounds today. We're going to be going over some song structure stuff. It's going to be a really fun video.
Yep, and as always, make sure you guys like the video and subscribe if you are new. That really helps us out a lot, and we're going to be talking about how you guys can get the rest of this content today if you wanted to.
Yeah, man, and share
in a little bit.
Share it with your producer friends, man.
We're trying to grow the community, dude.
So let's jump right into this. I want to talk a little bit about kind of like how Fisher does his songs, and then we're going to be doing some like sound design stuff. It's going to be really cool. So the first thing I want to kind of go over is like how he lays out his tracks. They're all like pretty much the same. I feel like if we were to lay out all Fisher songs together and just flip in between them, it's going to be the exact same layout.
You mean like structure-wise or
structure-wise.
Just like what elements are being used?
Both.
Yeah.
Both, actually. So let's listen to the drop one more time, guys, and I'm going to kind of show you what Fisher does. So we got like a really nice synth on that one, and then it goes straight into that catchy bass. Same thing again, but a little different of synth.
Yeah.
And then back to that groovy bass.
That bass is so important.
Yeah, so in Tech House and in Fisher House.
Fisher House.
I guess it's Fisher House.
He's technically House.
Yeah, he's definitely technically House. essentially, they break it down into kind of an A-B situation. So on the one, they come out with a crazy sound. It could be a synth. It could be like some saw synths, or it could be some weird...
Like effects
or
something.
Yeah, an effect, like modular effect. And then it goes into the B section, which is just a bass line, just a simple bass line.
Groovy,
though. So that's what the really cool thing is about Tech House, is it's very simple, it's catchy, all of the sounds make up the whole stereo field, which is really, really sick. It's awesome. So if you guys want to make your own Tech House song, you should definitely stick to this phrasing.
Reference Fisher for sure. And I have something to say about Tech House, which for all of you guys out there that produce bass music, or you produce trap or whatever, it is so important that you guys are versatile producers, that you can produce anything. And I will say this right now, because you'll never know. Like, I had a friend that does trap, and all of a sudden, like, you know, he started making a house song, and I was like, dude, you should do fucking house. Like, you're way better at this, dude. Like, your house is just like, sometimes you'll surprise yourself, and you end up doing a genre.
Yeah,
but
we usually do like a lot of heavy music on our channel, and like now we're starting to do a lot more house videos, and it's
just
so
fun.
Much fun.
Yeah.
It's like not as like heavy on the sound design, but like there's so many other aspects to it that makes it fun and exciting.
You're damn right. So beep beep, Zen World, we're coming for you, bro.
Beep beep, motherfucker.
And also too, like another big thing about Tech House is like I think, and we already know for a fact because of some of the labels that we're talking to, it is the wave right now. This is what everyone's listening to.
Yep.
So definitely familiarize yourself.
Familiarize.
I got that. Familiarize yourself with learning how to do tech house.
Is it like trap in the like 2000s?
It's
like
kind of, yeah, 2000s? It's kind of popping, like, bro. It's also fucking like summer, fall-ish, whatever, but yeah. Get into it, bro.
So so let's go over this first synth first. We're going to go over this drop synth. It's a very simple sound and really fun to make, and you guys can put this in all of your tech house songs. So like, I don't really hear crazy sound design in tech house. It's more simple. It's more kind of like sequenced sounds. Like you could make a tech house song on like a modular synth.
Yeah.
And kind of sequenced. So I don't know who produces like that at home, but it's kind of a cool, interesting way.
But it's the right sound. You know what I mean? The sound design isn't very hard necessarily, but to make it the right sound and the right fit for tech house, because it's so minimal.
Plopping it right in there.
Just plop a little. Beep.
Just plop that perfect sound.
Perfect sound.
So we're going to go over this guy right here. Really nice, nice chord stack, which it's not really even chords. It's kind of like low notes right here.
Like a lead, I guess.
Yeah. So we're going to go over that. We're going to pull open our Serum. We're going to take this off real quick.
No rack.
No rack.
Well, not for this one.
Yeah, not for this one. So we're going to start out with a saw wave on A, and we're going to do a saw wave on B. And we're just going to create some more voices, guys. So we're going to pull this up to 5, and we're going to pull this guy up to 5 as well. We usually like doing 7. That's Sebs. Kind of like the magic number, but for this one, we're doing 5.
Sebs 5s is always good, bro.
Sebs 5s. It's beautiful. And then we're going to put this octave up on oscillator B, and let's hear this. Let's hear how this sounds. Well, that's both of them. And there you have it, guys.
It's already done.
So it's pretty close. So you're going to want to really get this detune at like 0.21. You're going to kind of blend it so it's very balanced right there. Random all the way up. And I think that's about...
The level, I think, is what is...
Yeah, that's really about it. I think the level is normal on this. And then this guy is a little higher just to get that higher octave up on oscillator B. And then, you know, if you really wanted to, if it's a different kind of style, you know, if you threw a filter on.
It's kind of like a re-space.
You got a really nice re-space right there. So so that's really it for this page. Again, really, really simple. And if you guys really want, you can also add a noise. I really like AC hum, or you could use like bright white. But I feel like bright white was really, it was too aggressive for this one. Take that filter off. So if you guys want to hear that.
It already sounds big and rave-like.
Yeah. So sick. So that's really it for this kind of saw stacky thing. You can make this into a chord, but really tech house is very minimal. Very minimal stuff. Not a lot of chord progressions. Just really riding on that one note and kind of dancing around that one note.
And because it's minimal... Like, a lot of times people struggle with getting their synths big, like, yeah, really big. I mean, smoke this nugga notch.
Smoke that up.
Get high with us right now. Jesus, fucking
smoke in there.
Tornadoes flying in, dude. Fucking
just
people
tornado
are high,
right into
dude.
My lungs.
Fucking Waka Flocka's there with his eyes
brain
red.
Notch.
So, yeah, like, if you think about it, the minimalistic part of tech house is, like, the synths will sound really, really big. Because it's so minimal. You don't have to work really hard. Like, there's no processing on this. Like, it's
zero.
Just some sauce. I mean, you could do the effects part if you wanted to, but all it is just reverb and EQ.
Yeah, we're just cutting the lows on here, and we're throwing some reverb on. That's
but
it.
But the space itself allows that sound to just ring true by itself.
Exactly. So this is it for this sound, you guys. Before we go, I want to show you guys how to make the bass line in this, which is really cool. In Technically House, there's going to be so many... different like variations of this bass.
Yep.
There's gonna be pluck basses, there's gonna be like sub basses, there's gonna be like really cool, like filtered fucking, you know,
good groovy basses.
Like I have not been able to find any of those like online.
Yeah, any
like
good
tech house pack, or even just like a house like and they're not like hard to make.
Yeah.
But they're hard to like
to get right.
Yeah, it's like, it's the little things.
That's what I said
guys.
As a bass player. As a bass player, it's not a hard instrument to play.
Yeah.
It's a hard instrument to make sound right.
Dude, these bass players are going to kill you,
yeah,
dude.
Yeah.
They're
them,
coming
dude.
For you,
care.
Dude.
I'll smoke them at bass. What's up, bro?
Smoking them.
Slap it to bass.
Slap it to bass.
But yeah, like, I think you're right. Like, you know, this pack is going to have a ton of stuff. But also, we've even included, like, because Tech House, Technically House, the reason why we call it, is it also, like, kind of meshes with Bass House. And
yeah.
There's some bass house sounds in there too. There's a lot of different wubs and shit, so it's pretty cool.
Yeah, there is some really cool sound design, not in the classic sense of like hybrid trap or like dubstep or something like that, but it's very, very interesting.
Right.
So before we bounce, this is another really quick sound, you guys. Really fun to make. This is going to be this guy right here.
And the bass, the way it grooves with the kick too, is so good. Like that's another, let him look at the MIDI, I feel like.
And you guys look at, if you guys see the pattern right here, they're always coming back. And look, it's an A-B-A-B pattern. Always look at your phrasing.
That's the secret sauce to Fisher's fucking bass lines, bro.
Yeah, you gotta come up with a catchy bass line, and you gotta come up with this A-B phrasing. A lot of, like, top liners out there, if you guys are watching this, you guys already know about this. Songwriters, you gotta find the catchy phrases. If you're singing a lullaby, dude, that's a pop song.
Right.
Every pop song on the radio is a lullaby. So you guys want to lull everybody with your bass line, dude.
Omega lulls, dude.
Omega lulls.
Omega lulls your bass line, dude.
Exactly. So so there it is. Look at this. A, B, A, B, A, B.
And notice the walk down, too. They're just walk downs.
I might even make a whole video on that kind of phrasing melody. But this is going to be a little bit more of a quick video. But without further ado, let's get to this sub bass, guys. So the first thing you're going to do is oscillator A. We're going to go to analog, and you're going to pick filthy. So this is a filthy wavetable.
This shit stinks.
Filthy wavetable.
That's a fucking nasty bass,
dude. I think a common thing that we kind of found out when we were making all these different kind of sounds is really want to find a very interesting wavetable, kind of like this.
Yeah.
And you want to kind of oscillate it back and forth. So what we're going to do first is we're going to put this envelope onto the wavetable. And we're going to probably go to about 91, I believe. Mm-hmm. And that's how this sounds. But before I even play it, I want to do this. And we're going to create this envelope first. First, we're going to put this attack at 7.4. And we're going to put the hold all the way down. Decay is going to be at 651. And the sustain is going to be at -16.6. And the release is going to be at 3.1. It's going to look like this. It's going to be a nice little swoop, but with a lot of attack. So this is the first key into making your like really nice attacky bass. So this is what it sounds like when you put it on the wavetable.
Oh, turn out the filter so they can hear it.
Oh, yeah. That's a good idea.
Yeah, it's like a dirty sound that's filtered.
If you look at it, it's going back and forth right here. This is without it. So kind of boring, right? But this kind of rounds it out.
Mm-hmm. Gives it more movement, more life.
Yeah, and you can also sample like one shots of actual basses and make this and turn it into something like this. So that's really cool. And then next off, we're going to add this MG Low 24 right here to kind of clean up that high end. And then we're going to throw this envelope onto the cutoff right here, and we're going to pull this to 28. So this is going to be a little bit of a kind of just to keep the attack there, but also
give
it that little bounce. And I really like this bounce.
The right amount of resonance, too, is really important.
Yeah, so the resonance is going to be at 20%. The drive is going to be at 20%. And then the fat's actually going to be all the way down. If you wanted to get a little fat, that sounds good, but it's a little too aggressive. Again, you gotta be chill. Tech
chill
house
out,
is chill.
Bro.
You're on the rooftop,
We're
bro.
We're grooving, bro.
Drinking cocktails, dancing with chicks.
I took 7 hits of ecstasy,
with guys.
Dude. I feel fine.
Yeah, dude, exactly. You
I'm
feel
on ecstasy
fine, dude.
Right now.
This is the third night that we've been awake.
Technically the third night.
But yeah, so now let's get back to this.
Make
dude.
Sure you're also in mono and legato with that portamento too.
Yes, exactly. And then to kind of finalize this off, we're going to throw a little EQ on here, kind of controlling that high end. And then before we get into the post-processing, I always say post-production.
The Post
fucking
Malone.
Those video fuckers. The Post Malone. If you guys really like this project file, and you guys want to support us.
You want the sounds.
And you want all the sounds in this video. Even this beautiful acapella over here. Who's that?
I don't know. It sounds like an angel. That's all
sounds
I
like
know.
A freaking angel. If you guys want this, you guys can actually join our Patreon. Woo. And we have a YouTube legacy tier where we have all of our project files.
All of our project
all
files.
All of them. Like this.
And we got that. Oh, we got that thing going on with Patreon for the.
Oh my gosh! Yes, that is huge. So on our Patreon, we're doing a September special. I think we got half of September left, you guys. If you guys join a tier, whatever you are paying for that tier, you guys are going to get that percent off as a coupon code for any pack that you want.
And we did
on the website.
We tried to make a free tier for to give away like starter packs. Like we just dropped a mid-temp starter packs on there. We try to do it for free, but they don't let you put up free content. So if you want to just join the dollar one or the thanks one, you can donate however much you want. But we're going to start putting content on there as well as adding more content to the legacy tier and VIP tier every single month. You guys can go look and read all about it. But basically, the legacy tier, like Parker was saying, has access to all the project files plus an extra project file. And then VIP is going to have two extra project files on top of getting everything else.
Patreon is popping, you guys.
Go check it out. It's
go
popping.
Go join our fucking... Look at slam that Patreon button.
Thank you
slam
to all
it.
Our new patrons flying in right now.
Thank you, guys. We have tons of patrons. So without further ado, let's get to these effects.
Get
so
it, bro.
The first on the rack is a Utilts.
Utilts.
We're busting that up a little bit. 1.66. Get it louder. A nice clean gain structure. Mm. Next, we're doing an erosion. We're doing it at 3.75 KHZ kilohertz. And the width is going to be 1.3. And the amount is going to be 1.76. This is going to be really adding that bite.
A little sizzle there. If you don't have erosion and you're in a Fruity Booter or you're a Logic Xer, you can use texture.
Exactly. And then finally, we got a little auto filter just for cleaning up those lows. Yeah.
Just barely curving off the lows. I usually don't like to do that, but it makes sense in this case.
Yeah, because there's not a lot of elements going on, so you really want to kind of mesh everything together. You don't want to be doing very aggressive cuts. That's it, you guys. If you guys really liked what you see, drop a like, drop a sub, drop a comment. We've been doing some comments. We got to catch up to all the old videos.
We owe people some packs.
We are indebted to you guys, for real. But thank you guys for watching. We're going to play this out. Stay tuned for this Friday. We have another awesome Tech House video coming for you. It's going to be
a big
surprise.
And we're going to be announcing some more information that's going to really benefit you guys.
Tons of
A lot of great shit that's going to be happening. So we're really excited.
All right, let's play this guy out, guys.
Let's go ahead, bro.